Okay, welcome to Checking In With, presented by O'Neill. We are here with Chase Sexton, the big Triple Crown winner from last week. Had to feel pretty good to get your first win of the year, I'm sure.
Yeah, definitely good to kind of get that one out of the way. Everyone's always looking for their first win of the year, and I won it last year on the third round and then didn't win one after that, so got it again. Got it done again on the third round, but now we got to keep it going. So that felt really good and had a good week of riding, so looking forward to being back kind of on the East Coast, closer to Florida.
Yeah.
And excited.
When you crashed in the second one, were you like, I threw it away? Or did you think you still get the overall?
A little bit, but I knew that everyone was kind of mixed up. So I didn't realize how close we were until the race was over. But I mean, there was only one point separating four of us for the last race. So definitely a little bit of a, when I fell, I'm like, oh, like, there went my hard work in the first race. But I was able to come back to fifth. And then, get the win in the last race was really important. So, I'm stoked.
Was the third race win more satisfying than the first?
100%. That was probably my most satisfying Supercross win, like 250, 450. It was because it was really all or nothing. So to get that one and pass the guy that needed to beat was special. So,
overall, how are you feeling this year? Like pretty good?
I feel good. My whole goal this year was to start kind of, not start off peaking. I wanted to kind of build into the season, and that's still my game plan. We're on round four now, so just getting started. And I'm just excited to, like I said, get back to the East Coast and start getting on some tracks that are more what we're gonna race on for the rest of the year. So yeah, just trying to build into this thing and be there for the whole series.
How was off season training and all that up in Santa Barbara area?
Santa Barbara was really fun. Didn't get to ride this year up there, so I just did strictly off bike training, which I think helped me and definitely kept me back from riding, like as far as peaking too early. I didn't want to be on the bike for up 2 months or 3 months before the first season, especially because we had to race longer in the year. So I feel like last year I came in a little bit too ready for the first race and then kind of died off. So this year that I wanted to do the opposite and kind of just keep building.
Do you feel stronger this year physically than you have in years past?
Definitely. I mean, I'm just getting older. I'm 23 now, so every year I feel like I just get a little bit more mature and a little bit more fit and just kind of growing into my body a little bit. So it's been positive, and I'm still training with Peter Park, which has been really awesome, and it's taught me a lot.
Yeah. Do you ever look at things you've done in years past, younger, not as experienced, and just like slap your forehead?
Yeah, I still, like, even last year, even races this year, like San Diego and heat race, I didn't need to make a pass around Colt in the whoops. Like, I should have just kind of backed off, but instead I had to go crash and then have to go to the LCQ. So yeah, it's always an evolution of learning, and I've been learning a lot. So I think it's been good, and yeah, hopefully we can kind of keep those mistakes and ride more like a veteran is my goal.
How's the vibe on the team changed now that you're like the main focus or the number one guy and moving on?
I wouldn't say it's changed a whole lot from like the summer. My goal is to go out there and win no matter who's under the tent. So it's been good though. Testing has been fun with Cole being there. He's brought a lot to the team that we didn't really try before. So that's been positive. And then my goal stays the same, and that is to win. So it doesn't really matter who I have under the truck, really.
Yeah. So last week's kit was pretty cool. The Ken Block, tribute.
Yeah.
And I had to feel good to win in that.
Definitely was cool to be in that gear. I only had one set of it for the whole three races. So I had to get good starts, which I did, but then I crashed, which I didn't really get too dirty, because they were thinking I was gonna have to switch gear if I got it too dirty. So I'm like, no, I gotta keep this up clean. And was able to do that. So it was, I love red, white, and blue in general. And then to match one of Ken's suits was super special. Cool. And his family was there. So overall, it was really, really special night in Anaheim. So stoked I got to run it, and was pumped I got to win it. I'm actually gonna run the helmet again this weekend. So that'd be cool.
You're gonna get the gear framed up, I'm sure, right?
I gave it to the family.
Oh, so, yeah, that's cool. Have it, yeah. That's super cool. So we're at press day and you watched the little riding sessions. What do you think of the track on first glance?
Track looks good. It's very hard packed, which I wasn't really expecting, but tomorrow will shape up different. The rhythms look big and peaky, so should make some for some good racing. And overall, I think the track, last week's track was good. And I guess we'll see when I get out there tomorrow.
Cool. Thanks, bud.
Thank you.